Welcome back, all of you. Nana here. In the previous sessions, we have completed the costing setups and then the costing transactions. And then we have seen about how to do the trade accounting. And then what are all the cost components to be mapped to the cost elements so that what happens, you won't have any problem as far as purchasing is concerned. I will also give you a list later on for the landed cost management. For the purchasing and landed cost management, what are all the components which are required to be mapped actually to the cost elements that I'll be giving you later on. So in this session, I'm now going to talk about the cost adjustments now, as well as one big topic which I'm going to discuss is what internal requisitions transfer orders. It's a big topic. So these two topics I'm going to discuss upon this now. And let us now begin our discussion on the cost adjustment. And then I will now start our activity on this. So I go there. So here, what I'm going to do is I will now go to the cost management directly. You go to the supply chain execution and then go to the cost accounting over there. Let us now go and then query the cost item, the cost. So click on it and then we'll now see the item cost on this. So go there, go to the review item cost. We already costed the product now. So go there. And then it is B01_cost_test with item. And go there, click on it and then click on search. So once when you search for it, I made a mistake. Not here. I will have to give the item over here. So I'm putting the item over here and then click on search now. It's coming. Now the cost is $12 actually. If you review the unit cost, if you click on the review unit cost, it will not tell you about how it is now going to give it to you now. So click on the review cost, but the material cost is this much now. Fine, we have put everything on the same element only, and no other thing. The non-recoverable tax has not been done, only the item cost is only this much. So we have not used the other components, the cost elements like material overhead, resource overhead, and the outside processing. Those things have not been done. So everything is in the same cost element. Fine. So we can even review like this. Click on that. And then you can even, what happens, you go to the review transaction cost. Fine, click on the review transaction cost. Okay, click on it. It will not show you how the transactions are. So initially, we made a purchase order receipt. And then the purchase order receipt was costed. The transaction order is 100. And then you go there, transaction cost is 10. Fine. So what happened, the total inventory value is how much? 110 is 1000 actually. Then afterwards, we made a miscellaneous receipt now. Fine, we made a miscellaneous receipt. And then upon which, on the first transaction, the unit cost was 10 now. We made a miscellaneous receipt now on the second org actually, 500 quantities at a price of $20. So when these two things are compared, what happens? It made an averaging of it, and then 100 into 10 plus 100 into 20 is now averaged out. So the total value of the inventory is 3000. The total quantity is 200. So 3000 by 200 is now 15. And the rate came. And then afterwards, what happens? I made a user cost adjustment. I made it now, fine, for the document number 99. Once I do it, what happens? It has now come. And then I give a -3 adjustment, and then once when you run the distribution, it has got adjusted, and then the new cost is now 12. So this is how, what happens, you cannot see this now. The further details can also be analyzed over here now. So three such things are available on this now, on this place. So we have what on this place, review cost and transaction cost. It will not show you, just like in Ebis, what happens, you can also see this now. Now we'll again, I will not show it to you, fine. I will again do it to you. I will now make one more adjustment and then show it to you. Click on it now. I'm going to make one more adjustment. Go there. So I will now make adjustments, manage cost adjustments. I will now make $1 actually. Fine, go there. So it's again, what happens is a tree actually. Fine, I'm not going to create. I'm not going to edit. No, fine. I'll now use a create. It's a tree on which I'm going. Fine, click on next. So here, what happens? I go to first of all search it. Now, fine. One of the things you have to give it. Now, fine. Let us now put the item on the search it. B01_cost_test. Now, good app. So let me search it. Now, fine. That. So I don't know why two things are okay, but two different orgs it's coming. Now, fine. That. I will not choose for the first org actually. B01 is the org. Fine. Click on okay now. Coming. Fine. Click on search. It's also asking these things. Fine. This is a mandatory field. Actually. Sorry. All the three are mandatory fields actually. Fine. So I will know how to give the mandatory fields. Fine. Go to B01. And then give a tab now. And then here also. I will give a B01. And then give a tab. The cost book. So all the three are mandatory fields actually for search. I click on search now. I'm going to search. So once when you search for it, whatever, we'll be getting the results over here now. So go there, we'll now get the results over here now. So the search results have come up. Fine. Click on the next one. I will now go to the adjustment. Fine. First select it and then search it and then go to the adjustments. The next in the tree train, we are now going to the third activity. Fine, click on next one. So once when you go for the adjustment, we can adjust it in three different ways basically. We can even give a new cost or otherwise what happens, we can even give a percentage change also can be given. So that way you can do it now. I think we have to select the line and then afterwards give the next activity. I'm not selecting the line. So knight is no select, it goes, no come. Fine, I have to select the line and then give a next move. So it's fine. So we can even give a new cost to the item, or otherwise we can even say amount change or a percentage change. By one of the ways that we can adjust it, no fine. So let us go there and then give a new cost, no fine. There are two components which has come. One is a non-recoverable tax as well as item price. So item price I will now make from 12 to 11. So amount change is also coming. The percentage change is also coming automatically. So if you put one of the three factors, what are the remaining two factors will be basically populated over here. And then click on what I will not give a next. Okay? I'm going to wait now. So click on next. So it's now reason code is asking for and give a reason code. Material cost change. The material cost CMCC is one. I'm going to click on next. Very nice. So 12 to 11, the total new cost will be 11 as of now. So afterwards, once when you have done it, you go on the submit button. Click on submit. So there's a bit. So what I was a yes, submission of a cost adjustment 1099 for cost processing. Now it's not done. But now what happens if you have not saved the changes, you would have gone fine. Do you want to continue? I will not say you have not saved your changes, basically no saying fine. I will not give a cancel and then it will be saved also. Right? But I will not give a save also. Save is not coming, save and close. And then okay, it has now gone out of it actually, probably. So we will now make a check of it. The line has got vanished actually. So that might have taken shape actually. Use the item cost. So I have not submitted it actually. Fine, I'll go back. Then have a look at it. Go back. So I have to submit it also. Fine. I made some mistakes somewhere. Now fine. Go there. I'll have a look at it. So now that the total cost is there, give it back again. So this is what has. I will now edit the existing one. We'll now see what exactly is now fine. Go there. Click on edit and then become next one. We will now try to do it in a very proper manner. We'll go there. We'll now go on then query on this one. double is one. Find the item I'm going to query now. B01_cost_test. So click on search now. Searching for it. So now there are two lines which are visible actually. One is processed and then one is submitted. That is what we're saying. Fine. So this is now submitted actually. And 11 from 12 to 11 we brought it now. Fine. Adjustment status is submitted actually. So that means what? And nothing to worry about. Fine. That was 99 and then is 1099 is adjustment number. Okay. Fine. So 99 is already processed. You see now. Fine. 1099 is now submitted. Okay. Well, that's fine. Now what happens? We go there and then run the cost adjustment. So we'll not go there. We'll not give a save and close. Nothing come out of it. Doesn't matter. No need to think about that. I will not do this. I will not go to what. Will not do the run control. Fine. We'll create cost accounting distributions. I go there and then it does not run the run control. So I will not put my run control as B01 when you tab. It starts with B01. Thank you. On search now, it will show you my run control. So what it is. And then here we can only not have to adjust. Remember the cutoff date is the one on which what happens the people will be using it now. So today I'm in July and then they will now put a cutoff date at the 31st of March. So that what happens, all the accounting distributions will be made only up to 31st of March. And then afterwards, what happens, they will now create a draft accounting and then do the final accounting also. So company will be very. And remember, they will not run the scheduling process just like that. No, otherwise, what happens, the payables cost by the concurrent transfer cost to cost management. And then the receivables cost, import journal lines are all completed as well as the, what happens, the manufacturing. So I don't know what concurrents they run from manufacturing basically. So once when everything is reached the costing area, then only what happens is they will not run the control. They will not do it. So I'm not doing it. So just for different purposes, what happens, I'm not going to create a distribution. Click on submit process. And then there is no parameters for this one. Click on submit. So by which you're not running. So 648 is a concurrent which is not running. Now go on and have a look at it. Go duplicate. And then look at it. So click on the favorite icon. And then you go there. There is a monitor process there. Fine, click on the monitor process. 648 will be running now. So once when it is completed, what happens, you're going to see whether the cost has got adjusted. So during the run itself, what happens, you'll go there and then have a look at it. So give a save and close and then come out of it and then you'll review the item cost. And connect. So go there, click on review item cost. So it's in the process of coming now. The item is what? Paste it to there, coming back to the tab and then click on search. The distribution is running. Fine, we got it. So the total cost is now 11 actually. So if you go to the review transaction cost, you can see all the transaction costs are coming. And at the 99, what happens at the 99 document number, we got the adjustment of what? -3. And then with the 1099 document number, we got adjustment of -1 actually. So this is all about what happens, the adjustment of the cost. And cost adjustment is not complete enough. Now let's now go for the big topic. So take on that. We are now going to see internal requisitions and then transfer orders. It's a very big topic now. Now, if you go there, I go to the procurement. And then I go to the purchase requisitions now and go to the click on it. I now go to put the item for whatever your internal requisitioning and go to the click on the more task and then go to the internal requisitioning. So for creating an internal requisition, you must have the license of self-service procurement. If you don't have it, what happens? You not do it now and go to the click on it. So I will not say B01, I will not paste the item over here and then give a tab now. So the moment you give a tab, what happens? It will not say it is unable to, what happens? The source organization for the given destination type cannot be determined at all. So we have to define the source now, fine. So that is why you know saying. So the supply chain operations manager is now asking you, fine. Remember, supply chain operations manager is an important role as far as the supply chain is concerned, fine. So there are five roles which I told you, out of which what happens, this role is a very important role. So if you give this role, what happens, so many facilities are basically, what happens, facilitated for your scope, supply chain orchestration equipment. So the source organization could not be defined, fine. Okay, now fine, go there. Click on the select source, I manually define the source. So if the source is not defined, what happens, you cannot do anything at all, fine. We'll not go in the process of defining a source as such. So go there. So the first activity is what? We'll now go there, and then I will now go on that. Modify the item. Fine. Item has to be costed, which you already done now. Fine. So go to the product management, and then go to the product information. I don't know. The item attribute has to be modified. Fine. I have not what happens? Modified a template actually. Fine. I made a mistake actually. So I go to the browse items, and then I'll query the item. Now. So I'm now going to the browse items, and then I will now paste the item over here. Now, fine. Give a tab, and then let me query it. So click on search now. Fine. Another thing. So let me go and then do it in the master app and go to the thing. Or I will now directly go and then okay, master org and go different. So my master org is a B010 and then 1 and 1 2 or child argument. And go that thing on it. And then I will now go to the cost test and then try to modify the attribute actually. So here what happens? We have to enable the source means what the ATP has to be enabled. Fine, click on the specification form. And then I go there. And then on the planning area, I go to the planning area. So here go there. So here the ATP has to be enabled. So you can also find the planning method on MRP has come now, and then people say the MPS is also come now. Fine. As and when gradually it is coming, I don't know how much is coming. MRP is definitely coming. Fine. So it has to be there. Then only what happens, we can collect the item, otherwise we cannot collect the item. Fine. MRP planning or MPS planning also is there. You can make a check of it. I'm not sure about it. MRP will definitely work. So go there. So automatically expires and all these things. This is okay. So here nothing is there, nothing there. And then here what happens, you go to the sales and order management. The planning front is okay. So we'll now go to the sales and order management and then see. Okay. So here we have to enable the ATP actually. And so is a shippable, everything is now coming, invoicing is coming. Order management enabled. So these two things must be enabled. Fine. Transfer order enabled and then internal transfer enabled. And then always have the back to back also, yes. Fine. It doesn't mean that what happens you're going to do it. And then you can even make the returnable as also, yes, if it is not an edible item. Edible items cannot be returned, fine, nobody will accept it. Whereas some customers, if you are accepting returns, then what happens? It has to be yes. Otherwise, what happens? RMA cannot be processed as such on this one. You go there. So it's not going. I think it will be in the planning only. Look at the planning, or it may be in manufacturing. So safety stock is not coming. And automatically expiry is okay or something. It's the ATP check is a must now. And it may be in manufacturing. So I'll go there. And then look at the manufacturing. Supply is also there. Create supply is also must be enabled actually. That is for the planning central actually. So now the planning central has got split into three modules. That is what Vikram was saying on the other day. One is what the supply planning cloud, and then the demand planning cloud, and then sales and operations cloud. Right? That way it has got split actually. Right? There's now in the three modules. When I learn it, I will now teach you also. And right? Click on the manufacturing. So in the manufacturing, I think what happens is the build and loop must be yes. Now, right? This is a case in EBIS also. Fine. The similar one has been kept over here now. Go down. And then it's also there. No, fine. Costing is enabled. Input and roll up is there. where is that? Yeah, enable ATP. No, fine. ATP check. Maybe in the sales and order management. Or here is not there. No, have a close look at it now. Fine. So all this is the sales and order management. Check ATP will be there. We want functionality. No. There. Shippable is yes. No, fine. Invoice is yes. No. And go there. I will again have a look at the planning now. Check ATP has to be enabled actually. And automatically expire AS and the consigned is there, fine. So it must have gone somewhere else here. No, create supply, order forecast, everything is there, no, fine. Calculate ADB, yes. In the MPS planning, calculate ADB. And go there, click on it. So if this is enabled, what happens? It will be making a check of the ATP actually. Fine. It is a similar functionality what we have in EBIS. I'm not making a check of it. So MPS planning, what happens? I'm not calculated ADP, I'm making it as yes. It's a very important one as far as what happens. Internal requisitions, transfer orders come from fine, you enable it. And then one more thing is what, make the processing days as one day, because what happens is some aspect of your what happens if you're planning or other, what happens if your data collection will not work as well. Even though it is having a, what happens, a meaning only for manufacturing actually, but it is preferable to have it as only. In the manufacturing, you can see my videos on this, what happens on the, how the cumulative manufacturing lead time as well as the cumulative total lead times are basically calculated, as well as the fixed and the variable lead time, the fixed variable lead time, and then the processing lead time, how they are calculated, as well as the CMLT and CTLT, how they are calculated, along with the lead time, what size time, for my videos, it will be telling you exactly how the lead time management basically. So this is what I was fine. Calculated is there, fine, click on it. And then let me save it, and then what happens, give a save. Save and close. Now, let us see whether this change has been percolated down to all the child dolls. I made it in the master now. I'm not sure about whether the master controlled attribute or the org controlled attribute. I'm not very sure about it. I'll go there. I will go to the planning and have over it. Click on the planning and see whether it will come on. What about the check ADP? Yes. So it is the MCA only. So master controlled attributes cannot be modified in the child org. Okay, fine. Not done. And then I'll come on. So give a cancel. It's all done. So the item attribute is not modified. Now the first activity is what, you have to go there and then put it on the, what's called on the ATP actually. Click on it. I'll now go to the global order promising. So I will go to the order management and then I'll now go to the global order promising. And then I have to put it on the appropriate one. Fine. First is what, manage ATP. Go there. So click on it and then I will now go to the manage ATP. So the manage ATP is the first task in the internal requisition, internal transfer order what happens process. Now fine, go to the manage ATP. So check ATP is yes, now fine. We have to go and add it. So I will now make a search. Now fine, you will see this. Something will be there. So what I do is I will now go there and then try to add our organization. Fine, go and click on edit now. Fine, I'm try to add the organization. And go there. I will now go to the ATP assignment, rule assignments. Fine, go there. And then let me make a plus and then try to add my organization. The organization will not be available. Fine, I'm going to have an item organization assignment. Fine, go there. Our organization is what? B011 is the organization which what I'm going to assign it. So item starts with what? B01. And then make a search now. Fine, it will not be available. So we have to first of all collect this org. If you don't collect it, what happens? It will not be coming. Fine, go there. So if not coming, you can say, no, fine. First, we have to collect it. Then only what happens, it will be coming over here now. Fine, go there, click on it. And then click on done now. So for collections, what happens, we go there, click on it. And then you'll be having what, we have to go and then, I will now go to the planning area and then do and check also, fine, go there. So I will now first of all go there, go to the space. And then I'll go to the FSM area, fine, click on setup, and then I will now go to the planning area. In the FSM, what happens, I'm going to this area now, fine, go there, click on drop it down. And then I will now go to the planning actually. Supply chain planning. Supply chain planning is the area, fine, go there. I will now go to the supply chain planning. In the supply chain planning, I will now go there. On the configuration, if you see, and then you see all the tasks over here. Fine. We'll have a task called what? Manage planning source systems. So we'll now go there. Fine. Is a manage planning source systems. You know? It is not a scope specific, you can even run it outside now. Fine. Go there. And then I will now choose the OPS now. Fine. OPS, I'm choosing it now. Select the OPS now. Fine. Click on manage organization list. So click on the manage organization list. And then here I'm going to have a look at it. So go there and then we'll now have a look at what happens to the organization. Organization starts with B01. And then click on search now. The org itself will look at the organization. So organization starts with the B01. And then make a search now. So the org itself will not be available. So first we have to run a collection only for the org. And then afterwards only it will be coming now. So let us now run the collection. Fine, go to the right click and then go to duplicate now. So we are going to run a collection for the org. So go there and then here again, if you go to the supply chain planning now, fine, go there, click on it, and then you go to the case. Go to the setup and maintenance. And then go to the supply chain area. Fine. I'm in the FSM now and go there. Drop it down and then choose the supply chain planning. In the supply chain planning, I'm going to choose it now. Go to the supply chain planning. It's a big process and then watch keenly. And then if you have any doubts, you can write to me at nana.app60@gmail.com and go to the supply chain planning and then I'm going to go for all tasks now. And then I will know how to what? Collect planning data. And go first, I will now collect the org. Click on the collect planning data. I'm going to go to the. So the org must be enabled for collection now, fine, go there, drop it down, and then make it as the OPS now, fine. I'm not going to go for an edit change, actually, fine, go there, and then go there, and then choose the organization over there. The organization I'm going to select. The organization, I'm choosing it, and then I'm going to bring it to the right-hand side area, fine. As of now, the planning, the supply data, I'm not doing it anything, fine, go there, no supply data, only on the reference data, what happens, I'm now choosing the organization point, go there, then submit. So once when you complete this concurrent, what happens, the org will be getting collected. Thank you, the concurrent is running. So it is now saying, whatever, you're now referring, requesting a net change, and then it's not a targeted change. And then whatever, it'll know, prior should have been, for at least one targeted collection must have been done before we run the net change collection. No, fine, doesn't matter. And go ahead, click on yes. So the concurrent is now submitted. So I'm going to pause the record because it will not take approximately 5 minutes to complete now. Click on it. And then let me pause the record and then I will again come back. So the worker to delete stage data as a last concurrent find has succeeded. So it will go there, go to the planning system. So then select it and will now query for the organization and the manager organization just now. So we'll see whether the organization is correct or not. Click on it. And then let me search on the B01. Click on search. And search. No, still not available now. And you have to wait for some more time. Then only what happens will be coming now. So let us wait for some more time. So what you have to do is you go there, click on it, and then go to the manage organization list. And then you should not simply select it. Fine, click on the refresh organization list first of all. So you know, refreshing it. After refreshing it, make a search. Now, fine, refresh organization list. And then I'm going to go there, B01, and then make a search. Now, fine, you can now see organization list. So for me, I'm going to move it from B012 to 11 now, and enable both the things for collection actually. B011, enable for collections as well as B012 also enable for collections. So in this transfer orders, what happens in the internal requisition, internal transfer orders, I'm going to move it from B012 to B011. So I'm enabling both. Click on save and close now. And then I must have a sufficient stock in B102 for what happens, creating an internal requisition and transferring it from B012. Right? So the organization is now enabled for collection actually. Enabled for collection. Click on save and close. So afterwards, what happens? You don't go there. Click on that now. You now have a look at what happens. The stock now. Fine. You go there, put it in the place, and then either you have sufficient stock in the source organization or not. Fine. You go to the sufficient organization, and then I go to the inventory management, and then make a check of it. Let us now have a look at the stock. So go there, click on it, and then you now go to the item quantities now. Manage item quantities. So it now shows you both the organizations, all organizations now. Fine. Go there. So let us now check the item. Fine. Go there. Click on paste now. Item I'm going to check on all the organizations. Thank you. I'm show all the organization stocks. So B012 is my source. Now, fine. Expand it and then go there. So in the B012, we have 100 quantities, and then B011 also we have 100 quantities. Fine. Expand it. So we have sufficient stock in the source. Now, fine. From 12 to 11, I'm going to make it now. Okay, that's okay. Now we have intermediate. Now we will again run the collection. Now, fine. First time, what happens? We run the collection only for collecting the org. And then we have enabled it for collection. Now this time what happens, item and org, I'm going to connect. Thank you. So first time run, what happens, it is now, it brought all the org to the planning area. And next time, what happens, I'm going there. Thank you. And then I will now again go to the same navigation of the FSM now, fine, supply chain planning. Go there, drop it down and then choose supply chain planning. It's a big process, and then what happens, please take notes on how I'm doing it. You just have a look at it. Click on the supply chain configuration now. And then you go there and then go all tasks. So again, what happens, I collect planning data. So from the FSM area, I'm going over there now. Fine. In some cases, what happens, the supply chain planning will be coming as an icon here. Fine. In the navigator itself, will come as an icon. So you go there. You can even say it is an icon, but in some places, supply chain planning will not be coming as icon, in which what happens, you have to go via FSM only. Coming here, okay. So here, what happens, I go there. I will now go and click on the collect planning data. I will again collect, make it as OPS now. This time, item and organization I'm going to collect now. Item I'm collecting it, bring it over there as well as organization. So we go there, organization. So on the reference data, I'm now collecting these two things, and then I go to the supply plan data, and then I will now bring the on and also. So go there. So items, organization, and on and will be coming to the planning area. So let us now run the concurrent now. Click on it. So this much is sufficient. Fine. I don't think any item, because we have not made any structures as such. Fine. Even catalogs, we also not made anything. So let catalog also be brought. Fine. Catalog also sometimes may cause a problem. So let us now bring the catalog also. So item, catalogs, and organization, and then supply planning. What happens? You bring the on end. So go down and then click on submit. Now, fine. This concurrent will again run for about 5 minutes. So let me wait for it now. Fine. I'm now again pausing it now. Actually, it didn't got collected. Then what I did is I went there, collect planning data on supply chain planning. Then I gone for OPS, and then I gone for a targeted, and then I brought everything over here. And then here in the supply planning also, I have not brought everything. And then I ran the collection. But at least I think what happens, you have to do at least once targeted collection. So after the targeted collection, what happens, I'm able to see my org as well as an item in the planning area actually. Now we'll now go there and then do the ATP. I ran it, now I'm not going to run it again. So just to show you, about in the reference data, I brought everything over here, and then on the supply planning, everything I brought over here, and then I made a targeted collection. Now let us go there and then have a look at it now. So the ATP role, I'm going to create an ATP role now. First ATP role, I'm going to go to the order formatting, then go to the global order formatting, and then let me get an ATP role. So click on it, and then you go there, go to the manage ATP roles. I'm now going to get an ATP role. So click on plus now. We'll not get an ATP role. So will now go there. The name I'm going to give is what? B01_ADP_2. I'm creating a tool. So this is go to the rule criteria here, and then I will now make it for the supply chain planning. And then here I'm going to have what happens. I'm going to balance the demand and supply actually on hand, and then I will now have the fulfillment, and then go there. So there is no dependent work order is not there, and then supplier purchase orders and purchase requisition is not there, but internal requisition I will now enable it now. So some of them I'm enabling it. So at least on hand you are enabled in the demand side, and go there. And then you go there and then drop it down as and then make it as a user defined, and then you make it this 100 days. And this is very important. Otherwise, what happens? The demand won't be sensed as such. So I given these things now. Afterwards, this is for the components, and then enable profitable promises is for what happens your GOP's optimization, respect location constraints. Okay, no, select this one now. And then afterwards, I go to the what's called this is a supply chain planning, and then the lead time, and then the infinite based mine. I will go for mapping on this now. And then afterwards, I go to the rule assignments now. Thank you on the rule assignments, and then let me add it now. I go to the actions, and then go to add and go add rule. So I will now go for an item organization now. Item organization. So the organization is a B011, and then give it add. The item is I will paste the item, thank you, add. And then I will have one more thing. Thank you on personal mine. The second org also I will go to the item organization. And then I want to put B011 and then paste it. Yeah. So it's not B011, it is B012. So for both the orgs, I have now added the ATP rule. So give a save and close by which whatever the ATP rule is now completed. So when you do a save and close, the ATP rule is now completed. So having completed it, what happens? We'll now go there and then create our sourcing rule now. Fine. ATP rule is now completed. That's where we go there. And then we'll now create a sourcing rule. And go to the manage sourcing rules. So I'm going to source it for the second org to first org now. I click on plus now. I'm not going to source it. So I will now say B01. I will now say sourcing rule now. So sourcing rule, I'm going to make it now. So it's a local sourcing rule, it's not a global one. I'm going to the organization is what B01 reads it now. And then go there. I will now click on the plus, the dates will be coming. And then afterwards, go down in this place. I will now add the organization. I'm going to source it from B012 now. I can go to the type base of what transfer from. So I'm now going to make a transfer from organizations B012 and give it add. And then what else? I will now make 100%. And then this is a one as a rank. And this much is sufficient for the sourcing rule now. So the sourcing rule is now created. I go there, click on save and close. B01 sourcing rule is now created. So now have a look at it again, the local one. And then I'm now going to transfer from B012 to 100% allocation now. Go down. Having done this, we'll now go to the assignment set. So before we go to the assignment set, we have to see about which one is now used by a system actually. No, give a save and close. Come on, okay. So we have to go to the profile now. Fine, admin profile. We have to go there and go there. Put this up in maintenance. It does now go on and look at the admin profile. So to which assignment set the system is now pointing to? Go there. So manage admin profile. So here manage administration profile values, and then I know go on and query for the MSP default. Remember that is the MSP. Default percentage, man. MSP default sourcing assignment set. So MSP default assignment set is there. Fine, go there. Click on it. No, it is now pointing to global order promising. So in this assignment set, I'm going to make it now. So the MSP default assignment set on the admin profile is now pointing to global order promising. Go there. Cancel now. And then we'll now do this. Click on the now. We'll again go back. Click on the home icon. And then you go to the order management and then go to the global order promising now. And go to the global order promising. And then here. We are now going to assign this in this place. Click on it. You assign. Go there. You go to the manage assignment set. No, fine. You go to the manage assignment sets. Click on it. And then go to the manage assignment sets now. Manage assignment sets. I'm going with that. So you just make a search now. You'll be getting everything. So you choose the global order promising. Fine. This one, the profile is pointing to. Fine. Click on edit. And then I'm going to make entry volume. So click on edit. And then I'm going to give a plus edit. Go there. So this is again an item organization. Fine. Go there. I will now put the what happens item organization. item organization. So we have multiple things. Item organizations here now. The organization is B011. So item is you paste the item, okay, into the tab now. And then the sourcing rule now. Go there. And then the B01 sourcing rule can go there. Click on it, B01, and then give a tab. So that's it. What happens? Give a save now. Right, save and close. So we can even view the sourcing hierarchy actually. Once when the sourcing is completed, you go there again, edit it, and have over it. Click on edit. It'll tell you from where and all it's going to source. So click on the view sourcing hierarchy. And then put the item over here now. So we are not going to have over it. So It's not coming here. Now reset it. Not working as such. So where is it now? Maybe I had to keep it somewhere here. Click on the resizing and okay, I had to choose the things now. So we are unable to choose it actually. It must be selectable actually, fine. It is not getting a selectable icon at all. And, I'm going to give a save and close now. And again, come back and see. Click on edit now. Click on use using hierarchy. Still not coming. Right. So we are unable to see it. Otherwise, if you give all the values and then make a search, it will be showing you. I don't know why it's not coming. Okay, we'll never leave it as it's not. Close it. Save and close and then come out of it. And this is now complete. Then what happens? We had again run the collection only for your orchestration. This is the orchestration definition now. So we had again go on and run the collection. Thank you on it. Then go there. Go to the setup and maintenance. We had again run the collection. But this time only for the orchestration collection now. So go there. Go to the space. Go to the supply chain planning. So many times, three times you're collecting it actually, remember? So go there. And then go for the call task. And then go to collect planning data. So go there and then make it as OPS. And then this thing you can only run for a net change and then only for the this thing, right? Order orchestration reference objects. This is where we are now introduced the manage ATP rules and then sourcing rule and then assignments. And go there, click on collect. So this is only I'm going to collect it. So click on submit and which the collections are going on. So wait for some time to complete now. Fine. I'll now pause it for this to complete now. So the collection is now complete only for the order orchestration reference objects actually. Now what happens in EVIS, it is the IRISO, is the sales is involved actually. Similarly here also what happens, the sales is involved. So all the collected data must be available for the Oracle order management actually, for which we will now go and then run one concurrent called refresh and start. So the refresh and start will now make the things available for the order management actually. It's a refresh and start. So refresh and start and make a search now. So we're going to search for this concurrent method. We're going to click on it and then give it OK now and then run it. So normally what we have to pass on as a parameter is what we have to pass on the on-end. We have to pass on the ATP rules, allocation rules, the sourcing. Fine, these three things have been done now. ATP rules, allocation rules and sourcing. And then afterwards the items and then organization. But since it is the first time, what happens, this much is sufficient actually. But since it is the first one, what happens, I'll enable it with you. I'm not running it for the Patani Merigo. Yes, I can even. So I'm just having a doubt on this. I'm not running everything. Click on it. So this will be running. So once when this gets completed, what happens? All the items will be available for sales actually. These two also. But as and when you run it again and again, then what happens? You selectively choose on that one. Click on it. So we'll again wait for number 2 minutes now and then I'll come back and then see now. So the refresh and start order promising server is now completed and all the data is now available in the sales area. And then we have already completed the transfer order setups now. Fine. So you know it. And then now what it did is the setups are complete. Now we go on and create the internal requisition directly. Click on it. And then sign out of it now. And then click on confirm. And then let us know. Sign in again. So let's go there. Go to the procurement. And then I now go to the purchase requisitions and then I will create internal requisition also. From the second door to first door, we have to source it now. So go there and then click on the more task, then go to the enter requisition lines and then let us now put the item over here. So the item is, I will now paste the item and then you tab now. So it is for internal requisition. So the item is now placed. The source type has to be inventory actually. My inventory is coming. And automatically the source organization is coming. Previously what happened, it didn't came at all. And then we can now leave it for the movement request to choose the source subinventory. The movement request will now automatically choose the source inventory. Because there is a power of a move order or a movement request. Fine, we can leave it and find the source organization is coming. We can even select a different source if you want. So we have only 2 to 1. It has been done on the sourcing rule actually. Go there and then this is a destination for us. So everything is okay, fine. All the charge accounts, everything is coming fine. We are now seeing a lot of things on the charge account, but how to make it now. So on the transaction accounting definition also, we have seen it. I'm going to click on add to cart. quantity quantity. So we are now adding only one quantity. Okay, doesn't matter. Just for understanding, we're doing it now. The price is coming from the costing actually. Fine, we are now given a cost price of 11. So if the item is not costed also, whatever, it will not be coming as such. No, fine. There's no cost. So costing is also complete. The costing setups and transactions are complete now. Fine, there's no cost at 11 now. So sometime back only, what happens in the same video, I have adjusted the cost from 12 to 11. And so what happens, there's no coming to as 11 now. Click on the review. And then I will now see the approvers over here now. Fine, click on the manage approvers and then have a look at the approvers now. So it has to be what happens, the application developer now, so many employees are there, let us now modify the approver actually. I now made it, click on duplicate and then let us now modify it now. So let us now modify the approver, click on it, go to the setup and maintenance, then go to the manage requisition approvals now. Click on it. So click on search now. I want to have an automatic approval now and manage percentage, rec percentage, APV percentage, enter now. So go to the manage requisition approvals and let us now modify it now. So you have seen the stages and participants over here now, fine, that has been discussed long. And then click on it and then now edit the rule and then you know make it as automatic. This is a rule which is enabled actually, fine, go there. So here, another thing is there, go down. And then you know edit it and then make it as automatic. Now you are now set for supervisor hierarchy, fine, go there, make it as automatic. And then here, okay, fine. Now it is an automatic approval. So automatic approval, fine. Give a save and then give a deploy. So once it is deployed, what happens? We can now see the changes appearing on your requisition as what application developer is going to approve. So that way it will be coming. Then afterwards we can submit for approval. Go there, click on OK now. Fine, you go there and then click on what happens. Go back now. Fine, this many approvals are not required. Fine, I want to have an automatic approval. Fine, give it back and then give a save now. And then again click on the manage approvals. So this time it has to show me application developer is approver now. So once when it is approved, the internal requisition which is now made, fine, will be converted to transfer order actually. So we're going and see this now. So application developer is approved. If you click on submit, what happens? It will be getting approved automatically. The person who is now developing it is the application developer. 1025 is now made now. Now wait for some time and then have a look at this pending approval. And you can now see it gets approved automatically on this month. So you're opening it up and then have a look at it. Go to the right hand side and then click on the hyperlink on the pending approval. It will not show you who has talking moment. It's not yet developed actually. Fine. You have to wait for some time actually in this case. Now it has got approved now. Fine. 1025 is now got approved. So this is not done. You can now see everything. So we have to source it from org actually. So the delivery location is internal actually. So the delivery location is this. So we are going to have the source organization as a child too, and then the delivery location is the block one, which is now belonging to the child one actually. So having done this, what happens? You go there, you go to the actions, you go to the done, and then come out of it. 1025 is not done now. Fine. You know how, look at the transfer orders now. Fine. It won't take some time for the transfer order to get created now. So upon approval, what happens, it will be creating it. So you now go to what supply chain execution and then go to inventory management and then have a look at the transfer order. So the internal requisition now get converted into a transfer order. And go there. So I will now go to this place and then I will now go to what manage transfer orders. I've gone only for one quantity on this now, fine. The destination R is B01. So click on search now, fine, you know, get the transfer order coming up. So many things are coming now. So it's for one quantity, fine, you know, see, it's set to come on, there's no fine. Request count is only one now. So we'll wait for some more time. So things have been done. So the last one is the one which has been created as it's not kind of the transfer order. There's only one for one quantity. Fine, click on this 127044 is the number. So for one quantity, it has now got come now. So open it up and then here other people make it. Go there. So it is now going to go from the second off to first off and go there, click on it, and then go to the view shipment and zips now. It's now coming up for that, fine. So everything is now shown over here, and then you can now see it is not yet shipped actually. Fine. We had to go and then what happens? Do the picking now. So let alone do the picking now. Hang on the right click and then what happens? Go to the duplicate and then let alone do the picking on this one. Go there. So we have set up everything properly, and so what happens? The picking will not be a problem now. Go there. Go to the supply chain execution. So you're now aware of picking. Actually, the movement of the processing of the transfer order is already taught to you. Fine, go there. Go there. And then you go there. Go to this place. And then go to this place and then choose the shipments. Fine, shipments, I'm choosing it now. And then here, what happens? I'll go to the manage shipment lines. And then I'll put the order number. The transfer order number, I'm going to put it over here and then make a query on this one. So the transfer of number is what? Go there. I'm going to have a correct. It's 127044. Can go there. 127044. 127044. And what happened? And then again, schedule should date. What happens? I will not say before. Fine, tomorrow. Fine, something. The date is again another mandatory one. Fine, before 30th, then you okay? No, fine. So that what happens? It doesn't clash on the search as such. No, fine. Click on search. No, fine. It will be showing on this. Ready for this. And then we already have 100 quantities on this. No, fine. So we will not be having any problem on this. No. And then we want to make a search on this. 127044. So click on search. Right. The view the thing on that. So what you do is while making a search, actually, fine. If you go to the manage from clients, give a date which is now further ahead. Now. Go to the before now. Click on it. And then I give a future date. Now. Click on it before. And then give a date. Let's say 3rd of August. Now. Fine. I'm now giving a future date. Click on it. And then I put the number over here. Now. Fine. Click on it now. 127044 is the one. Fine. 127044. And then click on search now. So it is not coming. Fine. Go that. We'll now go on that. Launch the pick release actually. Fine. Go that. Click on it. I will now go to the actions and then go to the pick release. We are going to launch the pick release. So the pick release process will be triggering the WIC confirmation process also. The PR and the PC process will be getting completed in one go. So that we already seen during transfer. So this gets completed. And then the detail will be progressing from a release to ready to release to staged actually. So it's not done. You can now see the shipment number is also created. So the shipment number will be saying is now staged. Now fine. The 36186 will be getting updated on this page. Now fine. You can now see the shipment number. And go there. Click on done and then again re-query it. What happens? Will be getting the shipment number. Click on the view shipments and results. And then you can now see the shipment number is coming to 8166. It is now open now. So it is now in a staged place. Fine. We now go and then ship it. Now fine. Go to the place and then we'll now perform the shipment. Click on the shipment and then there's no staged area. So we all completed it. And so what happens? I'm going fast on this particular place now. So in the normal training, you will be taught each and everything on this. Now, fine. You already gone through this now. So I will now go there and then select the quantity to be shipped. Fine, go there one. And then here, the shipping method is a mandatory one. If you don't do it, what happens? Sometimes it'll be throwing another one. Fine, click on ship confirmation. So it may go. Otherwise, what happens? It'll be accepting. Fine, the shipping method is a must. Now, fine. So we have to specify it. Even though we might have specified it in the bottom. Fine, go there. So we have a carrier available here. Now, fine. In the line level, we are having it. But even then, what happens? The header level is also is asking. Now, fine, go there. Click on the method. Go there, B01 and then give it add now. The carrier is now coming. Fine. Click on ship confirmation by which what happens it will be leaving the second arc towards the first arc actually. And your warning message is coming. Accept the warning. Fine. Click on okay. Now fine. So now the consignment has started from the second arc and then it's now started going to proceed towards the first arc. Now it's now ship. Now fine. Go there. Put it in place. And then you can now see the requested is one. Now fine. The ship is not yet coming. Fine. Go there. Click on it. And then here, click on done. And then again come back into now and click on the view ship and some reserves. And now what happens you can now see there is no ship. So we have to go and then receive it in the destination org actually. Fine, we have to receive it in the destination org. So now the expected receive date also has to come based upon your transit times actually. Fine, click on done. So there is yet to come now. So click on view shipments again. Fine. So the expected receipt has to come now. So it is now closed. The shipment is now closed. And then what happens? It will now take some time for you to get the expected receipts coming up on this place. So there is a mess up on this now. Fine. When today is date is actually 29th of July actually, and then the requested date has been automatically pushed by what happens by a week's time, and then so what happens it is now saying only on 5th of August is required. So the actual ship date is 29th one, and then what happens the scheduled ship date has been pushed to 1st of August, and then because of which what happens the expected receipt date is not coming. Fine. So many date problems basically. So I have what's called a transit time now, fine, from second arc to first arc. So because of which, what happens, since I need it on 5th, it is now expecting me to ship it on 1st of August only. So that will be 4 days time. So let us now modify the schedule, what happens, the transit time to 1 day, and then the requested date also tomorrow. Now modify those parameters actually. So click on it and then go there. Click on setup and maintenance. Click on it. And then go to the search now. Go to the manage transit times. Manage percentage. Transit times. So go to the manage transit times and then query the second location to first location actually. And go to the internal now. And then drop it down. And then here I will say B01 and then give a tab now. So it's the second location. I have to choose the second location. Then the second to first, I will now make a search. Now fine, we have got only one pair available there. Fine, go there. Now the transit time is 4 days, and then I will now modify it. Now fine, go there, click on it. Let me modify it now to 1 day. So the transit time is now modified to 1 day now. Click on it. So click on it. Because the ultimate object is what I must get the expected reserve date. Fine, it may, you may have to wait, I think, probably. So because it is not coming. So I am now modifying this transit time to 1 day now. Fine, now let me modify to 1 day. So let me give a save and close now. Fine. Now let us now make a fresh requisition again. Now make a fresh position of this one. Go there. So we'll now go to what? You go to the home icon and then we'll now make a fresh position. Now the transit time is only 1 day now. And go to the procurement and then go to the purchase requisition. Now. And then click on the more task and then here go to the enter requisition lines. And then I'll now paste the item over here now. The item is now paste over here into the tab. The source gets auto picked actually because of our sourcing rules. And then ATP and then assignment rules. So I'll now say invalid destination. So the requested date, let me make a change. You know, not, is not coming as automatically shifted by one week actually. Fine, go there. So 29th is the date. Now fine, go there. I will now say requested date service 29. So we'll now make a change to 29th. So go there. I'll now make it as July now. So we need to create some for us. So requested date is free. So 29.7 is now needed now. So I will now go for the different quantity. I'll go for 5 quantity now. Click on this for this item. Click on add to cart and then it will now submit properly. So now 29 is a date of needing. Now find the request rate again. Is now showing something. Now find the, so it has not got auto populated over here. Now find there's a problem here now. Oh no, sorry. It is the next requisition line not showing you. So we have to go on and check on our cart actually. Go on and check in our cart and click on review now. So there you'll be getting the current requisition date. So it's around 9-7 of the date. So everything is now that fine. All these things are fine. Click on submit now. So 1026 is the one. So upon approval, what happens? It will be creating a transfer order automatically. So go there. And then you know, wait for the thing to get approved now. Click on the pending approval. It will not be getting the 1026. So once the internal requisition is not getting approved, what happens? It will be creating a transfer order automatically. Click on the pending approval. So now you can see the application developer has approved and then the task is also completed. This is coming. So now the status will not change to approved now. So go there, click on done and then come out of it and then see the 1026 having a date of approval. Now you go to the transfer order and then make a query. And go to the transfer order. So let's now make a query again. Now five quantities, fine, go there. So we'll now click on cancel now. Go there. So we'll now make a query again. Click on search again now. So this takes some time now, fine. We'll not combine the five quantities each has to come now. Source organization B012. And you it is already shipped actually. It is now away, it has to be awaiting fulfillment actually, fine. So the source type is now requisition actually, fine. Min-max planning also may be triggering what happens on a transfer order or inventory can be triggering. Now what happens, the requisition is now triggering actually, fine. So click on the requisition source. So it is the internal requisition source now. Click on it. And then come. So 5 count is coming. 128044 is the one. They're not coming. So it is not a fine. Click on the view shipment lines. It will not show you that what happens. The requested delivery date, scheduled ship date is also paid. Now everything is okay in line with this. So let us go there and then we will now go to the what's called go there and then verify. Go to the supply chain execution now. And then here go to the inventory management. Go up and then give a tab and then click on it and then happens, make it to shipment lines now. Find shipments and then you go to the manage shipment lines. And then the number is what? It is 128044. Fine, go there. So 128044. And then I will now make it as what before and then put some future dates so that what happens, it will not be having any problem. And I will now even today also it will work because what happens, it has to be shipped today actually. And today itself, it has to work. Click on search now, it has to work. Ship from organization is the wrong one. Fine, I will now make a change organization and then I will now go and make it to work. B012. So the organization is now changed and then I will go to the what? Manage shipment lines and then. I'll put the number 128044. So here, one of the good actions, then go to the pick release now. And then the pick release is now launched. So the data will be getting going to the stage now. Fine. From the release to ready to release, it will now go to the release to warehouse and then finally to the stage now. So click on it. And then the shipment number will be getting created also. Shipment number will be coming from again query. Now shipment number is yet to come now. It's on the way now. Click on search now. we're getting it. The shipment number is not created. So the shipment number will be getting updated on the main transfer order also. So the shipment number will be getting updated. Click on that one. I will go to this place and then keep it done and then come out of it. The shipment number will be coming. Click again in the view shipment lines. You can now see the shipment number has come. I have now open on 36187. So let us now go and then do the pick. It is already picked and then pick released and then pick confirmed. And then here I will now go to the works. I will now go to pie now. And then I will put the quantity away. Shipping method also. I will now put it in V01. So the shipping method is not coming from the confirmation confirmation. Why is requested 5? We are shipping it now. And click on ship confirmation. It is not getting done. So click on it. You can even ignore the messages because this is only for the transportation management actually. The weight and volumes are not being specified actually. So that's okay. And click on this. So it is not getting completed from the point. So it is not shipped, then what happens? It will be going over the interface. So once it is shipped, what happens? The expected receipt date also has to come up. Only when it comes, we can now receive on the receiving org actually. I click on done now. It is not shipped actually. I click on view, ship and reception. So it is not shipped. Then this date has to come now and it's still not coming. And then all of them are only 2 days date actually. So pick slip number is also done. The expected receipt date has to come now. Actually, the send shipment advice concurrent has not run now. So let me run it manually actually. If I go to the management process, now go there. So click on the schedule new process. And then send shipment advice, I'm going to make it. Click on it. And then the shipment number here is 36187. Then I'm going to click on it. So 361, and then give a tab. Just to confirm. Okay, it's 187. For which what happens? I'm now sending the shipment advice. Fine. So the same one from to two is same now. The message type is what shipment advice. So we are now communicating back to the calling application actually. Thank you, Consabi. So we are running it. So once when it is completed, I feel that it has to come now. So actually the expected receipt date was not coming actually. Then what I did is I ran this concurrent manage shipment interface. So once when I ran it, it was sending a lot of send shipment advice. So once when those services are being got completed, I was able to see on the transfer order the expected receipt date. So remember that if this is not coming, you can even run this concurrent manage shipment interface. This one you can run. So this place, if you see this now, you can even pass on these parameters actually. And the mode is what all know, not necessarily interface. And you all know. And the ship from org, D012 to the one, and then click on submit. These two are sufficient parameters actually for running the concurrent of managed ship and interface. So once when you run it, it will be going over there now. So it got completed. And so now it is now showing me the expected reserve date. So here, now go there. And then we'll now receive it on the destination org. So click on it, home. I go to the supply chain execution, and then I go to the inventory management, and then I go to receive it in the destination org. This place, click on it. And then I will receive it. Go to the receipts, and then receive expected shipments. So once when you give it, I will go there. And then in the, let me see, the main thing also, it will be showing you actually here. So it's not visible here actually. Expected receipts. Lines, inspector lines, no, it's not showing the space. Maybe the OR may be wrong actually. And so click on the expected shipments, and I have to change it to the first OR. So, okay, and the transfer order number I'm going to put it now. I made it going 128044 is the one. So, 128, and then we have no. So, it's not coming actually. And I click on search, no point. There's no expected on this place. And then if you click on this one, and you know that there's no shipped, it's not yet received as well as not yet delivered actually. You go to this place, and then there's no selected. And then click on receive now. Click on receive now. Go there. And then click on the show receipt quantity. Now it will now show you as 5 is now coming up in this place now. The 5 quantity is there now. The document number is the transfer order number actually. Now coming. So once when it is coming, what happens? You now create a receipt now. So we are now into the receiving section actually. So you cannot specify any sub inventory. If it is there, fine. Go there. You cannot specify any sub inventory. So we are now going to make a gate receipt now. Click on receipt now. So we are now making a gate receipt now. Click on submit. So we now do the packing slip number. So number of units, all these things will now populate. So this is an excellent value addition for you. So that when you take a report, we'll be able to give more information for the results if you are making it. Right? Click on submit, page which one of the GRN number gets created now. So 2015 is the GRN number, right? Okay, and then you can also this place. You can be having received also, right? Click on done now. And then click on view shipments. And then we'll receive not and deliver now. And 2015 is the GRN number, and we'll click on done. And then we'll not deliver it. So click on it and then we'll not perform put away transaction. And then 2015 the result number now. 0151. So give a search and then select it and then click on put away. So give it $5. Click on submit by which what happens, it gets delivered. So through this process, what happens? The entire IRTO is now complete. Internal requisition transfer order is now complete. It's got a lot of setups and then you have to do it very properly. Otherwise, whatever, it won't be coming properly. And then you go there. And then go to the inventory and then have a look at the stock now. Go to the manage item columns. And then I will know, have a look at the stock now. Item is what? Used to is a A is a B01 underscore cost underscore test 01. Go tab. And click on search now. It's not showing the quantity. So previously we have 100 quantities over here. Now 5 quantities has come over here. So I'm not showing that. So we can even see the transactions with the small happen now. 100 was the previous quantity, now it's not having 5. I click on that now. So go there, click on it, and then you go to the review completed transaction. Review completed transaction. Here, whatever you can have a look at it. So go to this item is B01. Let's go to cost. Let's go test. And then the days. I'll search now. So once I search for it, it will show you all the transactions just take a place on this particular date now. So you can even, normally what happens, the inventory in charges will be giving a week's period. Search it now. So initially we made a receipt now. So as a purchase order receipts, we have made it now as 100 quantities. And then now as a transfer order receipts, we got it. And transfer order income. So transfer order inter-organization receipts now. So this completes an IRTO find the big process. Try to understand it. And then the interface costing and then whatever they had to push it and then do the costing also. So the costing is almost similar. So all the information is coming over here. And that's it for now. We'll now meet on the next video, and then we'll see the next topic. So this completes the IRTO process, so which involves order management, because of which what happens, the global order promising has to be set up properly. So first of all, the ATP rule has to be set, and then afterwards the manage ATP rules, and then the sourcing rule has been created, and then finally the assignments have been done. Fine. Afterwards we did the collection, and then we did the refreshment start, and then we create the internal requisition, and then finally approve it, and then that gets converted into a transfer order. Goodbye. Thank you for watching my this video. So in fact, what happens, my trainings will be very in-depth, and then it will be covering the core actually. Fine. So join my training, and then get what happens, prosperous career. Bye.